Hi. In this presentation, we will go through a demonstration of Vivado and the Basis 3 port. After watching this presentation, I expect that you will be able to explain the main steps involved in designing a circuit using Vivado and that you will be able to repeat them by yourself. We will start by looking at the functional requirements considered for a small demonstration circuit, and from there on, we will create the project in Vivado and go through all the stages indicated here in order to program the FPGA and try out the circuit in the Basis 3 board. Let's start by the demonstration circuit. We will consider a simple 2-to-4 decoder with an enable input and active high outputs. Only one output at each time will be active according to the logic combination at inputs in 1 and in 0, except when the enable input is 0, in which case all outputs must be low. I assume that Vivado is already running and that you have previously installed the Basis 3 board files, so we can start by creating a new project. Click on Create Project on the left and choose a meaningful and preferably short name starting with a letter. Notice that I've already created a directory called vprojects at the root of my disk where my project folders are stored. Keep the Create Project subdirectory option active as shown here. We will choose the Register Transfer Level project type and keep the option Do Not Specify Sources at this time. Finally, we will specify the hardware board by selecting the Boards tab and then digilent.com and Basis 3 from the drop-down lists. You may notice that the target language defined by default was Verilog, so let's click on Settings on the left and change it to VHDL. The project has now been created and the next stage is to provide a VHDL description of the circuit and to check that we can synthesize it without errors. The logic diagram on the left complies with the functional table of the 2-to-4 decoder. The enable input is common to all four AND gates, so if it is 0, all the outputs will be 0 as well. You can also see that each gate implements a different product term, so only one output will be active at each time when enable is 1. This circuit may be represented by the VHDL description file on the right, where you see three sections, starting by the keywords library, entity, and architecture. Don't worry if you are not yet familiar with them. Just notice that the architecture section provides a direct representation of the logic gates and the wiring, shown on the left. We will now add the VHDL design file to our project. Select Add Sources on the left. Make sure that you have selected the Add or Create Design Sources option and click on Add Files. I have already selected the file shown in the previous slide, and all that is needed now is to click on Finish to conclude this step. We can double-click on the file name in the Sources window, and its content will show in a separate tab on the right, as you see here. We are now ready to select the Run Synthesis operation on the Project Manager window on the left. If there are no syntactical errors, the result of this operation will display as shown in the right. The absence of syntactical errors does not mean that the circuit will do what we want. So before continuing to implementation, as proposed in this dialog box, we will check if the behavior of the circuit matches our expectation. And we will do so by simulating its operation. Our simulation source is just another VHDL description file. We will not focus on its organization right now, but rather just look at the main section shown in this slide, which provides a very straightforward representation of the sequence of logic combinations driven to the three circuit inputs and of their duration. We begin by setting the three inputs to zero and wait for 30 nanoseconds, and then set enable to one and again wait for 30 nanoseconds, and so on. You may notice that we are driving all possible combinations at in 0 and in 1 while enable is 1. Since the simulation source file is already available, we will import it to Vivado by clicking on Add Sources as before, but now choosing the option Add or Create Simulation Sources. Once the file has been selected, we can click on Finish and we are ready to start simulation. We will select Run Simulation on the left and then Run Behavioral Simulation. The waveforms show that the circuit operates as we expected. Please pause the video for a moment and check that the outputs change in accordance with the logic combinations driven at the three circuit inputs. Since there were no syntactical errors and the simulation results were satisfactory, we are ready to program the FPGA. We will now need the third type of file required by Vivado to complete the project. The so-called constraints file associates the inputs and outputs of our design with the physical pins of the FPGA. Digiland provides a master constraints file that lists all the device pins, so we will just have to uncomment the lines corresponding to the pins required in our implementation. In this case, I'm using the inputs connected to the first three switches and the outputs connected to the first four LEDs. Notice that the original names in this file were replaced by our input and output names, which are represented in color. Since the file is already available, we will add it to our design as done before, but in this case selecting the option Add or Create Constraints. Click on Finish when the file has been selected. We can now generate the bitstream file needed to program the FPGA. This may take a few minutes, depending on the complexity of our design and on the performance of your computer. Once the file has been generated, we will be ready to open the hardware manager. And we have reached the final step. After opening the hardware manager, we have to click on Open Target and then Program Device. The bitstream file name shows by default, and all we have to do is to click on Program. The last stage is to try it out on the BASIS 3 board. A brief video showing the operation of the circuit comes up next in this playlist. The switches used are those at the rightmost positions in the bottom right of the BASIS 3 board, and the LEDs are those placed immediately above as shown in this slide. You should now be able to download the three project files and repeat all these activities by yourself. And that's it. Thanks for your attention.